Cash, dollars, dollars, that's all that I want. I need a bag full of it in the trunk. Give me plenty, I can't get enough. I flip a couple stacks, then I double up. Ay, pretty spiffy, cost me a pretty penny. Right off of the rack. Hi Varies, welcome back to my channel. It's Larisha Andrea. We are here with another It's Giving video. I know you guys are probably like, what the hell? The hair is already dyed. That's because I'm processing this hair two times. So I didn't wanna like show y'all the same content in the same video. So what I did was I just went ahead and filmed me just giving the base. Let me just start from the top. This hair is from Chambray Hair. If you guys do not know, Chambray Hair is a black owned company. I'm so grateful to be working with Chambray because I've been working with them since 2019 and they finally signed your girl as their first hair ambassador. So that's why you guys have been seeing Chambray in all of my videos. I feel like it becomes a lot more organic in my hair videos when I strictly have one brand of hair. So this is their Oriental deep curly hair. You guys have not seen me use any of their curly hair. I'm going to start introducing their Oriental collection that will be dropping within the next week or so. I will let you guys know in the description box when exactly date is, but I know the hair I've been using in my tutorials have always been a little bit pricey. That's because it's legit Indian raw temple hair. So for people that want to get Chambray hair but they felt like the raw Indian hair was too pricey, the collection I'm going to start introducing within my next couple of videos. I'm introducing all different types of textures, so I'm gonna be able to give you guys a more affordable side of Chambray hair. As you guys can see, this is the color that we're giving today. Obviously y'all know I never copy off of any of these celebrities' hairs. I always just remix it and just give my own little version. I'm gonna zoom in for you guys to see. You guys can see that it's all different types of colors, y'all. We have copper in the front. We have like a red magenta color in the back. We also have a different combination of copper and magenta all the way in the back. Like, I'm literally giving y'all all different variations of reds that will work perfectly for brown skin girls, dark skin girls, or even light skin girls. So I'm just gonna apply the color onto the hair like I did the first time. I used three colors from High Color Highlights. I used the shade copper, I also used the shade red, and I also used the shade magenta. So this is what the mixtures are looking like. These two are just four boxes of copper, just split up two and two. And I mixed it all of these with 40 Developer. So these two are copper, these two are red and magenta mixed together, two and two. This one is the red and magenta mixed together. And then this one is magenta and copper mixed together. Like I said, I did mix all of these mixtures with 40 Developer. I first used the Ion 40 Developer. This is a sensitive scalp. I already just had this sitting around and I had a full bottle, so I was just like, why not? But then your girl, I ran out of that one, so I had to go in with this Ore Cream 40 Developer. As I told you guys in my other bleach lightening video, I said that the Ion and the L'Oreal Cream Developers were my absolute favorite developers out of any brand. Honestly, all the other brands are bullshit. It's lies. They suck. Don't get them. Just stick to the Ion or the L'Oreal developers. Just trust your girl out. I'm just telling you. So this hair is still soft. As you guys can see, it is. I did brush it out with my fingers. The curls aren't as curly as they were when I first did it. You guys can see that the curls kind of loosened a little bit, but already I kind of knew that that was going to happen. So to apply the color, I'm going to take this spatula from Femar. This is my favorite thing to use when applying color on my hair. I'm going to start with the color copper, and then as I move on to every single different section, y'all know me, I'm gonna go ahead and stop the video and just explain what I'm doing. But if I'm not stopping the video, don't worry, I will put in caps anything that I do that I'm not explaining. So let's get to it.
Hey guys, so we have paused because we are moving on to the next section. Now we are moving on to the red and magenta section, which is all of this going on right here. I have 3 bowls worth of mixture. That should be plenty, you know, plenty of product. I'm just gonna go ahead and start on this side since this is the closest side for camera. And I'm just gonna do what I do. So this side is actually gonna be a little bit onto the frontal. When you are placing this red mixture on this frontal, please do not get it on the lace. You guys know every single time I do get to the lace, I do zoom in and show y'all how I apply the product. Just don't go and smack the product on the lace because this is red dye and it will, and I repeat, will stain your lace. Like I said, I will zoom in and show y'all exactly how I like to do it. So let's get started. So we are moving on to the last section, which is going to be the frontal. Well, last 2 sections, which are going to be on the frontal. This side and this side are going to be the magenta copper. So it's really nothing special to it. Like I said, I'm going to zoom in and show y'all how to properly apply these colors on this wig because you don't want to do too much product on the lace. I already have my magenta and copper mixture mixed up already, so let's get started.
Thank you. Okay, guys, so you guys know I always come and do a voiceover when it comes to me doing the styling. So this is the hair already air dry. Like I said, the curls did drop a lot, but I did go ahead and blow dry the hair a little bit before I showed you guys this scene. I'm going ahead to hot comb the frontal. Luckily, none of the hair color got onto the lace, so I was very nervous about that, but your girl did her thing when it comes to not getting any of that stained lace. Also, this color is so freaking pretty. I was so excited styling this because I was like, oh my god, this hair color is gonna look so freaking good on my skin tone. So like I said, I did go ahead and blow dry a little bit before I showed you guys the first scene. So I'm just gonna go ahead to blow dry the hair just a little bit more. Now, when it comes to styling, you guys, no lie, I just went ahead and just started cutting. I didn't even know how I was cutting this hair. I didn't know how to really get the style like how Kiki had in the picture from the beginning of the video in the thumbnail. I was just like, okay, I'm just gonna start cutting and then hopefully I don't cut off too much. But listen, I had no direction when cutting this. I just knew I wanted a bang, and I also knew that I wanted a little bit of layered wand curls. But I just layered it just enough and I cut it to about an 18 inch. I cut off a lot of this hair did start at 26 inches, but it ended up working out. So like I said, I'm just gonna go ahead to wand curl the hair. I did get this wand curler from Sally Beauty. I will try to see if I can find it and tag it down below. All of the items that I use in this video, as well as the Chambray website, will definitely be linked down below. You guys have been requesting Girla do her makeup in her videos, so I am finally giving you guys a makeup tutorial link with this entire video. So I'm going to be using a palette from Juvia's Place. It's their new bronze palette. I will make sure that I am tagging and putting in the clip the actual eyeshadow colors that I use. I did go ahead and use some concealer from Fenty Beauty. It's their brightest concealer they have. I believe it's 110 or 100, and I'm going to go in with that Juvia's Place palette. Like I said, I will tag in the actual video the actual eyeshadows that I did use, but I per usual just went ahead to freestyle this whole makeup look. I didn't really have an idea of it. I just went and let my hands work, and then we just went to creating. Okay, we'll be right back. when I have the eyeshadows placed on my eyes to my liking, I'm just gonna take this NYX white eyeliner pencil and just put this on my waterline and then go in with those same shades that I did use as far as the matte shades in my crease and just put those same colors on my lower lash line. I'm then gonna bring the entire look together by doing a wing liner. This is the NYX Matte Liquid Liner. I love this liquid liner. I just feel like it's just so good, so perfect, and it dries so matte. Move on to putting on some lashes that I got from the Beauty Supply store, as well as a inner corner highlight that I got from ColourPop from Ulta. Now we're moving on to the actual hair. When I tell y'all, I was so nervous and I got so frustrated when I put this wig on because, listen, when I saw it on a canvas head, I was like, oh my gosh, this is so freaking cute and so pretty, but it definitely needed some work, y'all, okay? I went ahead to put the wig on, and as you guys can see, the hairline is just looking freaking phenomenal. This is a glueless wig, so I finally have mastered making a glueless wig. I only put an elastic band on this wig, and when I put it on, it was nice and taut, not too tight in my head, and this lace blended in so effortlessly. And I put no spray, no glue, no nothing on this hairline. And as y'all can see, this hairline is looking phenomenal. Like I said in the beginning of the video, I did use a Swiss HD lace frontal from Chambray. And I didn't even tint this lace frontal, y'all. This lace frontal blends in so good with my skin. If you guys want to see how to make a glueless wig video, please let me know down below in the comment section because I will gladly make that for y'all. So when I was looking at this wig, y'all, I just started taking a razor and just cutting the ends of this hair because I felt like the ends were a little bit too blunt for my liking. So I just took this little razor that I had. It's actually an eyebrow razor. I didn't have an actual hair razor. I will make sure after this video that I go and purchase one, but on hand I did not have one, and I was just like, listen, this wig is not coming together. I had to take a freaking deep breath because I started to get so frustrated because the wig just was not looking the way that I wanted. I came up with the idea to just go ahead and comb out the curls. I was nervous to do that at first because I was like, what if I comb it out and then it's not curly anymore and then now I just literally ruined this entire wig. As I went ahead to take this pick, I actually got this pick from Pattern Beauty. I took the pick and started combing out the hair. I don't know if it's because I use a pick and not a comb or what, but as I started combing out the hair, the curls didn't mess up or anything. It started giving me that nice frizzy big look that I was going for. I don't even understand what the hell is going on in the back. Bae just in the back doing like some weird shit. I don't really know about this scene, y'all, but I finally started to like the wig. I started to feel like, oh my god, it's actually coming together. It's looking so freaking cute, and I was just so happy with it and just so freaking satisfied. So when it comes to the parts of this wig, I always like to take some powder. It's actually just a random powder that I got from CoverGirl and PR, but I just took a powder that is close to my skin tone, make sure it's matte, it has no glitter, no shine, no nothing to it, and put that on our hairline. I'll take my finger and just rub that over top of the powder just to make sure it blends in a lot better. And then I just went ahead to seal in by powdering my face with some Laura Mercier translucent powder just to seal in that shininess that I had around my nose. I was just going in and just making sure that the wig was looking nice and good. It was fluffy enough to my liking, and I'm just so freaking happy and satisfied with this entire wig, y'all. It finally was coming together. Like I said, I was a little bit nervous at first because I'm like, F, this wig took me 5 days worth of editing and pictures and all this stuff, all this freaking footage. It really went to waste. But listen, your girl never gives up. That's one thing I'd say about y'all when these wigs, when it comes to these wigs, y'all, do not give up, because if you just take your time, relax, take a deep breath, everything will come together. I'm not done yet, y'all. I am going to be finishing up with this video by giving you guys an outfit inspo. I just feel like I'm going to start doing this moving forward with my wig videos, because listen, if you have a good wig, a good makeup, and a good outfit, honey, the entire wig is going to come all together. I'll make sure I'll leave all of the outfit details down below. And that is it, y'all. Thank y'all so much for watching this video. I look forward to seeing y'all in Thursday's video, and deuces, y'all.